Several years into a water shortage crisis, California continues to be challenged by many users needing the same precious supplies. Fish agencies are required to protect fish and river systems. Adult fish need enough water flowing to migrate to their spawning grounds upriver, and juvenile fish need enough flow to migrate out of the river system to the ocean. Some endangered salmon also need cold water releases from lakes to make sure the temperature is cool enough for them to survive and reproduce. Farmers and ranchers use and need water from lakes and rivers to produce food that feeds millions of people nationwide. Making the most of what water is available has necessitated innovation and adaptation by water suppliers, fish management agencies, and agricultural producers.
When I have all of my irrigation going, it's costing me over $1,000 a day. And so if I can shut off my irrigation for 10 days, that's $10,000 somebody just handed me in cash. Soil moisture sensors were able to do that. It's the one employee I have that works 24 hours a day, never lies, gives me the most important information that I could ask for, is when do I need to irrigate, when do I need to shut it off. I think people need to start putting in soil moisture sensors.
You know, everybody's going to the shorter time period, maturing season variety of rice for a couple reasons. One, it just uses less water. And then secondly, we just have, you know, more of a condensed growing season.
We do what's called a pulse flow, where we turn the irrigation water back into the creek for a couple days to stimulate the fish migration. You've got a base flow that's mandated of 50 CSF. I mean, they have what's called a pulse flow, which is a doubling of that flow.
Water supply agencies are working closely with fish management agencies to provide water for salmon, but salmon survival remains threatened.
Winter run Chinook are our most endangered run, and they spawn below Shasta Reservoir, and they're completely dependent on man-made manipulation of the cold water pool in Shasta Reservoir in order to produce suitable temperatures for spawning and egg incubation.
We're making efforts to relocate fish into the Livingston Stone Conservation Hatchery. That's a triage type of effort, and I think we'll definitely get some higher survival from the fish than we would if we left them in the river.
Livingston Stone supplements winter run Chinook salmon in the Sacramento River. Last year, instead of releasing a normal number of 200,000, we released close to 600,000. NOAA, the California Department of Fish and Wildlife, has asked the hatchery to take in increased numbers again this year to produce as many fish as we can here at the hatchery, because they feel the fish would have better protection here and we'd have a greater chance of getting some sort of survival throughout migration through the Golden Gate Bridge.
Leaving enough water in rivers for endangered fish to conserve their remaining populations while also having enough water for agriculture and food production means being flexible, utilizing technology, and adapting existing practices to fit present-day needs. Building relationships to problem solve for salmon during the drought is also a critical factor in saving these fish. As you'll see in NOAA Fisheries video, Working Together, the Voluntary Drought Initiative